Today we're going to look at equivalent fractions, decimals and percentages, and we're going to look at the key ones that you should know off by heart. Okay, so let's start off with a half. So a half, if you've got a pizza or a cake or whatever, you should know already that a half would be like that. It would be half of it, like so. In other words, one out of the two sections are coloured in, okay, are selected. Okay, so one out of two. So that's why it's a half, and that's what it would look like if you were to colour it in. One out of the two, if you asked to shade in half of the shape, it would look like that. A half is the same as 0.5. Obviously, if you do 1 divided by 2, you get 0.5. And that is the same as 50%. So if you ever see a half, you can also think to yourself 0.5 or 50%. These are all equivalent to each other. If you were asked to shade in two halves, well, two halves would be one half and two halves. So you're actually shading in the whole thing if you shade in two halves. So whenever the numerator, so the top of the fraction is called a numerator, is the same as the denominator, the bottom of a fraction is called the denominator, whenever they're the same as each other, it will be the whole, okay, or one, or 100%, okay? So a half is 50%, or 0.5, and it would look like that. Two halves would be the whole thing, and it would be one, or 100%. Okay, a third. Well, if you were to colour in, if you had this shape and you're asked to colour in one third of it, that'd be one out of the three sections, obviously because all three sections are equal size. So a third would look like this if you were asked to shade it in. It would be one out of the three, like so. As a fraction, a third is 1/3. As a decimal, if you do 1 divided by 3, you get 0.33333 forever, okay? It's 0.3 recurring. Some people write it as 0.3 with a little dot above it, okay? And that would be 33.3 recurring percent, so the 3's go on forever, or 33 and a third percent. Two-thirds, well, if you're asked to shade in two-thirds of this shape, you would shade in 2 out of the 3 sections, so 2 out of 3, and would look something like this, two-thirds. If you're obviously colouring it a bit better. That would be if you do 2 divided by 3, you get 0.6 recurring, or 0.666666. If you actually do that on your calculator, you get 0.666666, and it does a 7 at the end. That's because the calculator has to round it to fit it into the display, but technically it's 0.6 forever. And that would be 66.66666% of with the 6's going on forever, or 66 2/3%. Again, if you're asked to shade in 3/3, so remember you would shade out 3 out of the 3 sections, that would be the whole thing, like so. And as we've seen earlier, whenever the numerator is the same as the denominator, what 3 divided by 3 is 1, or that's 100%. Okay, now let's look at quarters. So, 1/4, so 1/4 is called 1/4, and if you were to shade in a quarter of this shape, it would be 1 out of the 4 sections, like so, 1/4. That would be 0.25. or 25%. So 1 divided by 4 is 0.25, and that's 25%. 2/4, well, if you were to shade in 2/4 of this shape, you would shade in 2 out of the 4 sections, like so. And then, obviously, as you notice, that 2/4 here would be the same as a half, because 2/4, as you see, you've shaded in half of the shape. So 2/4 is the same as a half, and that's 0.5, or 50%. 3/4, if you wanted to shade in 3/4 of the shape, you would shade in 3 out of the 4 sections, like so, 1, 2, 3, so 3 out of the 4, 3/4 of, like so, and that would be 0.75, or 75%. Okay, this time we're going to look at fifths. So here I've cut a circle into fifths, each 5 sections of equal size, and if I wanted to shade in a fifth of it, it would be 1 out of the 5 sections, like so, 1/5. When you do 1 divided by 5, you get 0.2, so 1/5 is the same as 0.2, and that would be the same as 20%, so 20% of this shape is shaded in. Let's do 2/5 now, so that'll be 2 out of the 5 sections, so 2/5, and 2 divided by 5 is 0.4, and that would be 40%. 3/5 is 3 out of the 5 sections, like so. And that would be 0.6 or 60%. So 60% of this shape is coloured in. 4/5, so that'd be 4 out of the 5 sections. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So you've shaded in 4/5 of it, 4 out of the 5 sections, and that's 80% or 0.8. And finally, 5/5, as we've seen earlier, that would be the whole thing shaded in. So the whole thing would be shaded in if you wanted to shade in 5/5. And that would be the whole, or 100%. Okay, now let's look at eighths. So if I cut the circle into eighths, or eighth section, so if I wanted to shade in 1/8, it would be one section like so. Now let's look at this for a second. If you were to consider a quarter would be 2 of the sections like that. Now as you notice, 1/8 is half of the quarter, okay? So if you have 25%, you get 12.5%, or that would be 0.125. So 1/8 is 12.5%, or 0.125. If you're asked to shade in 2/8, well, that would be 2 out of the 2 sections. And notice that makes a quarter, so 2/8 is the same as a quarter. And that's 0.25, remember a quarter is 0.25, and that's 25%. You can see you've shaded in 25% off the circle. 3/8, well that would look like so. 1, 2, 3 sections, like so. Obviously you've got a quarter, which is 25%, plus on another 12.5%, each one of these is 12.5%, that would be 37.5%, or 0.375. So 3/8 is 37.5%, or 0.375. 4/8, well that's going to be 4 sections, like so. And notice that's half of the shape, so 4/8 is half. That's 50%, or 0.5. 5/8, well that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5/8, 5 sections. Notice you've got half of the shape, that's 50%, and another 1 section, that's another 12.5%, so that would be, if you add the 50 and the 12.5 together, that would be 62.5%, or 0.625. So 5/8 is 0.625. Okay, let's move on and have a look at these ones. So 6/8, well that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sections. And if you notice that that makes 3/4 of the shape. If you look back at the 3/4, that would be 3/4. So that is 3 out of 4. Okay, 3/4. So 6/8 is the same as 3/4, which is 75%, or 0.75. 7/8, so that would be 7 sections. 4, 5, 6, 7. And again, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's going to be 75% plus another 12.5%, which would be 87.5%, or 0.875. So 7/8 is 0.875, or 87.5%. And finally, 8/8, you would shade in the whole thing. And that would be a whole, 100%. Okay, finally, let's look at the tenths. Okay, 1/10, well if you were to shade in 1 section, 1/10 would look like that. And 1/10, if you do 1 divided by 10, you get 0.1, or 10%. If you look at it, 10%, 20%, 30%, 40%, 50%, 60%, 70%, 80%, 90%, 100%. 2/10, if you were to shade in 2 regions, 2 sections, you would get that. Now if you look back, that's the same as 1/5. So 2/10 is the same as 1/5, and that's 20%. 3/10, well, it would be 3 sections, 1, 2, 3. So 3/10 is 3 sections, that's 10, 20, 30%, or 0.3. 4/10, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you look back at the 2/5, it, remember it looks something similar. If I just get it now. 2/5 here. Is the same as this, so that's also 2/5, or 40%. Notice if you half the 4 and half the 10, you get 2/5. So you can actually see if you can simplify it down. 5/10, well 5/10 would be half of it, if you cover it, if you shade it in 5/10, so that's 50%, or 0.5. Notice if you divide both of these by 5, you would get 1/2. Okay, so 5/10 is the same as a half. Okay. Next, 6/10, well that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And notice that 6/10 is the same as 60%, or 0.6. 7/10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 6/10, by the way, is the same as 3/5. If you look at the 3/5, that is also 60%. 7/10 is 70%, or 0.7. 8/10, 1, 2, 3, 4, five, six, seven, eight is the same as 4/5. And they're both 80% or 0.8. And finally, 9/10 would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 out of the 10 sections. So it's 9/10, which is 90% or 0.9. And 10/10, as you remember, if the numerator is the same as the denominator, it's 1. 10 divided by 10 is 1, so it's 100%. You're shading the whole thing. Okay, so I would recommend watching this video a couple of times, writing down these key fractions, decimals, percentages, so maybe pausing the video at different sections, copying down into a table your fractions, decimals, and percentages, and learning them off by heart. It's very important you know all those off by heart.